Welcome to our tutorial series. In this video, we will explore how to integrate a VIOSO calibration into Unreal Engine through the nDisplay system. Our hardware setup for this demo is four Windows machines, a master connected to a full HD monitor and three clients each connected to one WQXGA projector. First, in our VIOSO software, we perform a 3D multi-client calibration of the projectors. Find out more about that in the link in the description. Once we're satisfied with the warp and blend result, we go to File, Export Mapping, choose the VESA MPCDI V2 format, check Export to Master and 3D boxes, choose Gray 8 or 16 as a bit depth, then let's name our file F1 for example and click on Export. We will have a compressed MPCDI, as well as a folder containing PFM geometry files and PNG blending masks for each display. Now in Unreal Engine, we set up our nDisplay project either by using the provided template in Films and Television, or by adding the nDisplay plugin to an existing project. Once we've finished designing the application, we package it for Windows. And here we get our build. Now it's time to configure nDisplay. This is the most crucial step where you define your hardware setup and integrate the VIOSO calibration. A good way to start is to open an example configuration file from our documentation or from the nDisplay content folder. The first parameter is the clusters. We define one for each of our four machines. Type in its IP address and define a window for each. Then we configure the windows with the appropriate coordinates and resolutions. Our first cluster will be rendering a 1080p window on a full HD monitor, while the clients are in WQXGA portrait, therefore 1600 by 2560 each. A viewport will be assigned to each window and we configure those in the same way, making them cover the whole window space. Next comes our MPCDI configuration. We do it by assigning the projection type of the viewports to MPCDI, then define the paths for our PFM files as well as the PNGs. Optionally, we can edit the alpha, gamma and scale factors. For our unwarped monitor, we need to manually define the screen for its projection, and we do so by defining its physical size as well as the location of its center and direction. Finally, we set up our default nDisplay camera in the origin of the scene. There's a lot more parameters provided that we can optionally add, such as the sync policy, network timeouts, and input tracking devices. For this demo, we're going to keep it simple, so we go ahead and save our file. The final step is to gather all our files in one folder. It is highly important that its path contains no spaces and that it is the same on all machines. So, we have the package build with the .exe, we put the configuration file we just saved, our MPCDI folder export F1, and then add the nDisplay launcher and listener that we grab from Unreal's installation path. Under Engine, Binaries, .NET. This folder needs to be placed in a shared drive across all clusters, or we can manually copy it to each machine in the same location. We have here a remote access to our three clients, so we open the folder and execute the listener on each machine. On the master node, we open the launcher, add our application in the list, add the configuration file here, and we're all set. We send a quick kill command to check if we're properly connected. We see the response on each machine, so now we're ready to run the application. And here we go, our application rendering is nicely distributed on all the clusters, with our VIOSO blending and warping applied to the curve screen. That's it for this video. If you want to know more, please check out our detailed integration guide provided in the description. Thank you for watching and see you next time.